I've been thinking over this a lot, and I thought it would be the best signal and also the most interesting project if we don't focus this on the money side, but I want to focus it on the community side and the people side. Because it's actually not really hard to get money for film. But the more money you accept from investors or from film studios, they will start becoming the owner of the film. So you will make a different film. It will be a more commercial film, and they want to own it. It will be difficult to make it open source, and it will be difficult to share it. So, do we want to have an open film? Do we want to have it open source? Do we want to have a film which is actually an open production? And there's only one way to do it, and that is to do it with you guys. With everybody around there who says, okay, I will support a little bit, and these $12-$13 per month, you can have it. And by the end of this period, I will have everything to produce myself. In the Gooseberry project, the ownership is with the makers, but the makers agree on releasing it as Creative Commons. And the makers agree on having a specific period of 3 months in which we will try to get some money out of it. In that period, the film, the final film, everything is in the cloud, but the final film is not available for the public. And somebody can say, I want to buy that period. I want to have this 3 months and put the film in cinemas, or put it on Netflix, or put it wherever they want, and I will pay for that. That money then goes to the makers. Not to me, but to a big production company. The deal is the makers get paid. I'm not going to help Hollywood to do their business better. I mean, they know how to make film, no problem with that. But I think we, as makers, as community, as Glendale community, we should try it ourselves. The main topic is make Glendale a better product. It's about hiring lots of Glendale developers to work full time on the software, but combine them with artists. It's not good to only put money in development, you also have to put money in making things. And by combining that, you actually make much stronger software. And I think for open source, it's a more natural way to do that than for closed software. And open source resembles how, for example, in Pixar or DreamWorks, they work on their own in-house software. They're not using software for themselves. They use their own software, develop it with artists and with the developers and make film out of it. In the Gooseberry project, we do the same, but then we will release the software for everybody to use, and we also open up the film for everybody to look at how we did it and to use for any purpose directing. We have a number of targets which we want to work on. Cloth and hair simulation. We want to unify physics and animation systems. We want to fix the particles in Blender. We fix cycles. We will work on freestyle cartoon rendering. We want to have threaded animation that every unit will have at least one technical person on board. So usually when I talk about 80 artists, actually I mean 65 artists and 15 developers, something along those lines. But there will be a nice gray area between the artist and developer too. Many people do technical scripting, or they know how to make rigs, and they can help with the coding. So there's an overlap. But at least every studio should have somebody on board who knows how to fix bugs and who can handle the code. The Blender Cloud will give the subscribers access to the same backend as being used by the makers and the developers. So you can follow progress from storyboarding, from all the concept art, from the writers, from the first shots and breakdowns and the modeling and the designs up to the final and when the film is finished. We expect it will take 18 months. So if you stay on board for 18 months, you will be able to see how the film starts from zero to a final product. So one of the key aspects of the cloud idea is that it doesn't only give you access to seeing what people do, but we also add methods for people to write about it, to share in forums about it, and to contribute back. Somebody says, I need a model for this specific shot, but the community can also say, well, I'm starting modeling, you can post it, and if it's a good model, it might be picked up by one of the teams and being used for the film. People can also use it for asset browsing. We can have standard sets of cool materials and rigs and models for people to inspect and to load, but also to give them their own space to upload data, to share data, to have versioning of data, or even have a small project space shared with others to do short film or games or whatever together. That's a very interesting use of the cloud system. Plus, because we are going to test making a film, we also have to render the film, so we need a good render farm or render services working in this cloud system as well. So once that is working, we can also roll it out to all the cloud members that they can have access to the same quality of rendering services. So all those aspects of what you get nowadays in the cloud from commercial companies, we are going to develop that as well. Good services, but we keep everything open. The Blender project needs ways to get a solid and reliable income. We used to be able to do that mainly through an internet shop by selling books and DVDs. But people are not buying that many books anymore, they're not buying that many DVDs anymore. So what I say, selling plastic and wood is not really a business. And because we are an open source organization, we should not sell data, right? Our data has to be free and you should be able to share it. So we need to find a way to have some kind of a system where data and software and content is continuously developed and where it's interesting to pay for it. So the Blender Cloud concept is to become a new revenue model for Blender Foundation to support our own projects, for the developers who are active with Blender, and also to create learning material and content for people to learn from. So this is an experiment, but it's going to be very, very interesting to see where does it go. So yes, I think we started a bit slow, and of course you can always prepare better. On the other hand, in my experience as doing open source, I've always learned that you should go open as quick as possible, because it is never finished anyway. This is new. Nobody ever did this before. We have to find out how to do it. So like this, like that. We listen to people, say, well, maybe this is a better way, and then it iterates, and then at some moment we think, okay, now I think we have a really good message, we have a good campaign, we have a good system, now we can start for real. And the first 2 weeks, but they were a bit slow, who cares? We're looking at the next 3 weeks, how's that going to work? Blender is really much bigger than 10,000 people too. And we need all of them. Everybody can be helping us in all the ways that I would like to do. Which is tweet about it, put it on Facebook, tell it to people, go to the website, download our banners or the press kit, talk about it to magazines if you know people, make a lot of noise. And for the next week, I really want the internet to start talking about this unique moment in history. Of course, I wouldn't do this if it would be easy, right? That's not fun. So you have to do something that you think, 5,000. Okay, I think we can do that. That's the 10, right? That's more impossible. And if we make it, then we really have something cool. Because, and that's the simple truth, with 2,000 or even with 5,000, we will not get enough money in to make the film. 1.5 years, having 70, 80 people to work full time on it, This is not a Disney film. We don't have 200 million, but we try to collect like 4 or 5 or maybe 6 million euro to do this, which is extremely low budget. Out of the 6 million, I would like the Blender community or the cloud members to contribute 1/3. 1.9 million, that's what we will get from the cloud if people stay on board for the full 18 months. The others is already being taken care of. Normally, if you crowdfund a film, you pay and then you wait. And all the interesting perks you get, they have nothing to do with making the film. You get a card or a poster with an autograph. You can visit the film set. You get many things, but you don't get the film. You might be happy if after 2 years you get the film on a DVD. But in between that whole period, everybody is locked out. In our project, we think it's much better if you don't pay anything up front, but you pay every month a little bit, you can see the film progressing, and then you get something like a live performance. So, if you think we don't make it, then I would ask you to go to the Blender Cloud and subscribe, because you will get your money back, or you don't even have to pay. There's nothing to lose. If you really believe we don't make it, you should subscribe.